Hi there, Lloyd Machedo. Speaking to you from LloydMachedo.com. Who's Lloyd Machedo and Think Personal Branding? I just thought I'd share with you the three biggest drawbacks of working in the Middle East, especially in Dubai, UAE, okay? Or in the Middle East in general. These are the three biggest drawbacks. The first drawback is the visa, okay? Now, this is one of the primary reasons why many talented, gifted, and smart people don't want to come down to the Middle East. Because what happens is, when you come to the Middle East, whether it's Saudi, Qatar, Bahrain, Oman, Dubai, wherever, you, in order to get a job, in order to stay in the country, you have to get a visa. And if you don't have a visa, they'll throw you out. And if your visa is cancelled, you have 30 days in order to get a new visa. So your life revolves around the visa. If there is no visa, you can't stay in the country. So your entire existence is based on that work permit, that visa, that residence visa. And because of this, many people don't want to, you know, they don't want to change their life chain, you know, be a slave to a company whereby they can't change their jobs, they can't leave their job, because without a visa, you can't do anything. Now, that doesn't mean that people don't come to UAE. Yes, there are many people who do. So, in my opinion, the biggest drawback is the visa. I'll also give you the solutions for it, okay? The first drawback is the visa. The second biggest drawback of why people don't want to come down to the Middle East is, you know, the illusion of having a good life. Now, you speak to anyone, they would say that it's tax-free, you don't have to pay tax, you don't have to pay luxury tax, you don't have to pay, automobile tax, you don't have to pay, income tax. But here's the thing. Life in Dubai is, life in the Middle East is not cheap. You're paying for housing, which is a rent. You're paying for road tax, you're paying for parking, you're paying for fines, you're paying for the education. Now, this is not cheap. Let me assure you, this is by no means cheap. If you're staying in Dubai, if you're living there, only then you'll realize. In fact, here's a nice little suggestion I'll give you. Speak to anyone who stays in Dubai. Speak to anyone who stays in the Middle East. Ask them how cheap is the school fees compared to your home country. How cheap is transportation? How cheap is having a car? How cheap is the rent? I'm pretty sure when you compare, you'd find more or less the expenses kind of negate, you know, they kind of prove to be more or less the same. Like, for example, I give this as my favorite example. I have a villa. I have a private villa here in Thailand, which I'm paying roughly, $2,500. When I was in Dubai, I was paying $15,000 for a single apartment. Now, consider $2,500 versus $15,000. What I was paying for food here, I can survive if, when I compare it to Dubai, one day's expense of food is like 6 to 7 days expense here. So one day is equal to 7 days. So, you know, when you stay in Dubai, you need to live like a person who's staying in Dubai. You need to, you can't drive, you can't ride a cycle. You have to take a car. So obviously you have to take a car loan. You have to pay for AC. You have to pay for the rents. Rents are pretty expensive. There's no cheap housing there. Insurance, school fees, transportation costs. So yeah, the second one is expenses. The third one, one of the biggest reasons why drawbacks is what's next. You have to understand the fact, once you start working in Dubai, all your experience is based in the Dubai market. once you leave Dubai and you go to, let's say, Canada, you go to France, you go to Germany, you go back home, they're going to tell you that whatever experience that you had in Dubai is null and void here. Where is your local experience? Where is your experience of this market? And that is where whatever you're doing in Dubai is only good enough for Dubai. That is why children who study in Dubai, that education is only valid in Dubai. You know, whatever work experience you have in Dubai is applicable only in Dubai. In fact, one of the biggest things is locals are given higher jobs. The top jobs are preferred, are given preference for Western expatriates or people who know Arabic and English. So where does that leave you? Where do you go from there? So one fine day when you have to leave the country, obviously you cannot be employed forever. Nobody's going to give you a work visa forever. One fine day you're going to lose your job. What do you do next? Where do you go? And if you do decide to migrate at the age of 50, 45, 50 or 60, who's going to give you a job? What are you going to do? Start from scratch? Start a new business? What about the expense to settle down? Have you thought about all that? Or yeah, are you going to just retire? If you're going to retire, how are you going to have a daily income? So these are the things people don't consider. So if you ask me, these are the three major drawbacks. Number one is a visa, where you are enslaved to a system. Second one is the expenses. Life, like in Dubai, is not cheap. And the third one is, what's next for your future? If you can answer these three questions, well, then you're on the safer side. So what is the solution for this? There are solutions. It's not that there are no solutions. Obviously, if there was no solution, nobody would be traveling to Dubai. Nobody would be applying for jobs. So the solutions are pretty simple. You need to have a strategy in place. You need to make sure that the legal contract favors you. You need to read in between the lines. You need to have a proper salary. You need to have proper, remuneration. The severance package has to be agreed upon. When they cancel your visa, you need to have an understanding between you and the company that they don't cancel your visa. They give you enough time to get another job. You also need to keep in mind that once you do lose your job, you're allowed to apply for other jobs, even if it's your competitor. And last but not the least, I think you need to plan out what your wife is going to do, what your children are going to do, because it affects everyone. So I'll make another video with regards to this. What do you do after you lose your job? What are the options? And what should you do when signing up for a legal contract whereby it benefits you? So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Like the video, give it a thumbs up. Don't like it, thumbs down. This is me signing off for now. Take care.